Hey, this is Mattias with Propellerhead Software, and in this recent sound design video, I'll give you some tips on using send effects in your music. So what is a send effect and why would you want to use it? Well, a send effect is an effect that's used in parallel to the original signal, meaning you mix in the treated sound with the original sound instead of replacing it. It also means you can send multiple channels of sound to the same effect. This is traditionally used for reverbs and delays, where you might want many sounds to be in the same space. One of the tips I find most useful with send effects is quite simple actually. EQ your sends. Just like with your instruments, the effect also adds a sound to your mix. Making sure this sound sits right is just as important as getting the instrument itself to sit right. A typical example of this is removing some low-end rumble from a reverb. Here I have a room reverb set up on a drum loop. As you can hear, it adds a nice ambience, but the low end is really kind of muddy. So what I want to do here is insert an EQ after the reverb. So I'm going to create one. Route it in. To the EQ and back to the return. And then I can remove some low end. Much cleaner, right? Another trick is to use sidechain compression on send effects, for example reverbs. This allows you to make sure the reverb never clashes with, say, a kick drum, and can be great for making your tracks pump if that's what you're after. Here I have a synth line set up with quite a big reverb on it. So to compress this reverb, I'm first going to add an M-class compressor and route it in. Then as my sidechain source, I'm just going to take the insert effects output here from my kick drum into the sidechain in. Now if I adjust the compressor, you can hear the reverb starts ducking for the kick drum. That's a really useful effect. There's a lot of talk about parallel processing, especially when it comes to compression and distortion. This is actually something you can do quite easily with send effects. I'll start by creating an etch red here as a send effect, and load a patch. I can now add this sound to my drum loop I've got going here, letting me add a bit of character to the sound without actually affecting the original signal. You can do the same thing with compression, and because it's up to you how much of the affected signal you want to return, you can be quite extreme in the settings on your compression or distortion or any other effect for that matter. A final trick that I've found very useful is to return a send effect not on the effect return, but on a separate mix channel. This means that things like EQ, compression and gating can be done right on a channel strip that also controls the level of the send effect. To set this up, just create the sound effect as you'd normally do. Then create a mix channel. Flip the rack around, and instead of going to the effect return, take the sound effect and pipe it into the mix channel. I can now treat this effect, this reverb, on the mix channel and even add insert effects to the sound effect. That's all for this video. Hopefully you got some ideas on how you can use send effects in clever ways to spice up your tracks or improve your mixes. If you try these techniques out, don't hesitate to send us an email with your track to productspecialist@propellerheads.se. Until next time.